All right, guys, girls, welcome to another episode of Astral Auto Repairs. Can you dig it? Yeah. All right, check it out. We got here is a 2003 Nissan Maxima, and we changed the front catalytic converter in it. Check out the video. But what made me want to, I want to do a video because I know I haven't seen one out there that really going to explain to you, like when you go get your OBD2 inspection, and they say, well, your check engine light is not on, but you got to drive it more to reset the monitors. I'm not going to get technical with this, but I'm going to show you the nice, easy way of resetting the monitors yourself by using my favorite scan tool, the Actron. All right. There's a lot of, you guys be like, you know, he used the Actron a lot. Yeah, it's a very powerful tool if you just know how to read it. And there's a lot of other handheld equipment out there that's around the same price range, $100 to $300, that will do the same thing. I'm familiar with the Actron, and you might be familiar with other things. The other guys with the high dollar stuff, you know, they can probably do this, but the Actron is very convenient. You know, you can throw it in your pocket. It's a cool tool. All right, what we're gonna do is we're gonna have to reset the monitors on this Maxima. Nissans are pretty quick for setting monitors. Stop listening to these guys. Yeah, you know, you got your O2 monitors, you got your fuel monitors, your catalytic converter, your EGR monitor. You gotta set them a certain way. You gotta drive it 500 miles and blah, blah, blah. Bull dookie, all right? It's plain and simple. I'm gonna show you how to do that. I'm gonna show you to hook up the Actron and let the Actron tell you when you can go. All right, now before we get into this, number one, some counties does not require OBD2. Like here in North Carolina, I believe it's Enfield Enfield or Halifax, that it doesn't matter what the year your car is, it doesn't matter. They just got safety, which is pretty cool. But here in Rocky Mount, Nash County, it is. Now, when I go into this and show you what the monitors are, you got to remember this. When you have about between 5 and 7, maybe 10 monitors that has to be set. But if your car is 2001 or above, you're only allowed to have one monitor to say incomplete. I'll show you what that means. Anything below, well, 96 to 2000, you're allowed two. All right? So enough of that jibber jabber. Let me hook up the Actron and I'm gonna show you exactly what I'm talking about so you can get a better understanding. If you have your Actron, get outside, pause the video, go outside to your car or anybody's car, hook it up, and I'm gonna guide you through that also. Instead of hooking up the Actron, you put up there, read codes and all that. This is gonna, we're going into special tests. All right, we'll be right back. Damn, I'm a good teacher. All right. Put the Actron here on the floor, and the first thing with you now, resetting your monitors will not, it ain't no good, doesn't pay to do that if your check engine light is on. So this is only for when your check engine light, or if you want to beat the check engine light, if you want to beat that OBD2 inspection, check this out. What you do is, especially if you got a bad catalytic converter, this reset the codes, and a catalytic and an EGR takes a while to come back. The code to come back. So you drive it just till the monitors are set and rush your butt down there and go get it inspected. Check that little tidbit out. All right, let's see here. Let's get up under here under the dash. Connect this. Now, what we do is get over here. But when this wire is cold, man, it don't. You see all this snow out here? Dang it, man, what the heck happened over here? All right, let's put our key in the on position. Dang, nothing but blowing out, nothing but cold air. Dang it. All right, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna go hit enter, as of right now. Now what you wanna do is go, and you can go into European or Asian, when I'm here, the global, keep, enter, enter. Now what you want to do is go down to what's called special tests. All right, Now remember, this is the Actron CP9135. Hit enter. Now, you see that right there? You got drive cycle monitors, state OBD2 check, OBD check. So if you go down to that, and I like using this, you use this if the car is standing still right now and off and on. So you go there. And while it's connecting, could have sworn I just cut that radio off, man. Good thing it ain't loud. Dang it. Man. Okay, there we go. We linked. I just cut the volume down. Okay. Now, if you see the codes found, 0. Monitors okay, 3. Monitors incomplete, 4. That's not good right there. Now, O3, automatically, when you start the car up and drive, I mean, just down the driveway, you're going to set them 3. That's just that easy. But those other 4, it's a problem. Now, being that this is a 2003 question, how many monitors am I allowed to say incomplete? Great. That's right. 1. So I'm only allowed 1 over here. Now, let's go back. Now, so what I'm going to do is go back. Now, when I say if I want to check the monitors and I want to know exactly when they're cleared, so or in other words, complete to be able to go get inspected. So what I want to do is go up to drive cycle monitor. Now, this is cool because this one, and it's good to have somebody else in the vehicle with you. And they hold the Actron. Well, you just, hey, go driving, go to McDonald's, go, you know, Burger King, whatever is out there. And you hit drive cycle monitor. Now it's going to commit. Now, you see what that's doing? Now, what the Actron is actually doing, it's constantly checking each one. That's right. And as I'm driving, they're going to, one another one's going to disappear. Now, as I said, the catalyst. Wow, the EGR is good. The EVAP system is another one. Those two does take a long time to go. So if you have a bad cat, you can do this. And pretty much, you're going to get it down to that one and be able to get that car inspected and don't have to worry about it until next year. So that's a little trick. And I guarantee you that works because our number 22, our Cougar, when we bought it, it had 3 bad cats because it was a tune-up problem. Cleared out every year before I get it inspected. I hook this up there and I go drive it and it's good. All right. So now as you can see, this is constantly going down. So what we're going to do, we're going to start the vehicle up and we're going to go for a little test drive. Now it's a little very slippery out there because of ice. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drive for a couple seconds, and we're gonna pull to the side and we're gonna check out how many monitors are incomplete. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a notice of the time to see how, or better yet, we'll go by mileage. We'll take a look at the mileage and before and after, so you get an idea of how long you gotta drive. And as I said, Nissans are pretty good with that. All right, so let's start this car up because it's really cold and I gotta warm it up, and I'm we're going to take a note of the mileage, and we're going to get ready, all right? I'll be right back. Okay, here we go. Inside our yard right here. You can see, if you can see in the street right there, you can see the streets are kind of icy on the side road, so we're going to carefully get out of here. Now, on our mileage, 264,913. We got no quick engine light or nothing. Okay, let's go ahead and see... it must have came off when I shut it off. So we gotta go back in here and okay, we're gonna go into global, keep it, go down to special test, okay. Now we're gonna be moving, so we're gonna go into the drive cycle monitor. I'll hold this thing steady, man, at the same time. Okay, let's see if we get that hole right there. It figures, man, this thing is in. Okay. out here with my yellow tie on, looking quite debonair. All right, come on, let's go. We got places to go. Enter. Okay, as you see, we got four incompletes. Being that this is a 2003, we only allowed one. So I'm gonna set that down over here. And as you can see, the Actron is constantly checking each of them, going back and forth, you know, checking them. So let's get this thing in here. Let's back up. Now what we're gonna do, I'm gonna drive it. It's like it's 264913. I'm gonna take it about 2 or 3 miles or so, and do a checkup, see where it's at. Okay, here we go down the road. And still checking them. All right, now being that there's ice out here in the road, I'm not gonna try to videotape this all at the same time. That's gonna cause an accident. Look both ways before I come to the stop sign. Okay. All right, we have four. I'm gonna take it till about 264916. And then we're gonna come back and we're gonna see where our monitors are set, all right? We'll be right back. All right, just a quick look, 264913. We'll go down here to the monitors. See that? Already. We got one down, two to go. Everything's looking good. Now, your catalyst is a good idea to get on a good stretch of road, doing about 55, 60 miles an hour. Really get that cat heated up, really set that monitor quick. But it's, as I said, Nissan's is very good for setting them quick. So don't listen to them when they say they'll do about 300, 500 miles, blah, 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 and all this junk. All right. Okay, we just turned to the 914. We still got our three over there, but we didn't get to our 3 miles yet, so I'll be right back. All right, we just hit 916. Still got three. All right, I'll see you at 920. I'm about to get on this call 301 over here, so I can be able to get up a little speed, go about 50 miles an hour, as long as the road is good, and we're gonna check it then at 920. I'll see you then. Okay, we're coming up to a light, which is good. We're at 919. We still got the three incomplete. So I am going to see you at 925. Dang it, I got caught. This light changed that quick. Son of a biscuit. Ugh. All right, no problem. All right, so what are we sitting over here? Sitting over here, three incompletes. 264,919. No check engine light. Everything is good so far. So I'm gonna get on 64 because this road is a little bit slippery. I need to heat them cats, heat that cat up, especially that one we put in. All right, so I'm gonna see you at 925, or when if a monitor sets before that, I'll let you know. All right, we'll be back. Okay, we're at 925. Still three monitors, not set. We're on 64. See you at 9:30. Okay, little update. Hit the 9:30, no check engine light. Still three monitors. See you at 9:35. All right, little update. We're at 9:32. We still got three not set. I noticed on some vehicles what I did was stop to the side somewhere, shut the vehicle off, wait for about 10 seconds, and turn it back on. I'm gonna try that. But as soon as I get off 64. So I'll see you in a little bit. Remember, we're at 932. Still three incomplete. Be right back. Okay, we're at 935. We're getting off 64. And still three incomplete. 935. So I'm gonna go over here, get off, and I'm gonna go somewhere and park, pull to the side, shut the car off, wait 10 seconds and cut it back on. Alright, be right back. All right, we're at 9:36. We got 303 coming to a gas station right here. Look at this windshield, man. Pull in here and hopefully they got someplace I can wipe this glass off. Let's see, do they? What kind of gas station is this, man? Are you kidding me? What kind of gas station is this that don't have the thing to wipe? Oh man, you talking about? Man, I gotta sit here. Am I missing it or something? Yeah, it's down there, but they don't have no things to wipe the windows with. You know, what the heck you supposed to use, your hands? What the heck? But while I'm here, I'm gonna stop. Let's put this car in park. And, let's shut it off. I wanna wait a few seconds, and this is gonna go out. So, I'm gonna go back. No power, so this ain't gonna do nothing. All right, there we go. Alright, so let's put our. We gotta wait some seconds. Sit here. Why? I don't know. Don't ask me why. I just know how to do it. Alright. Alright, let's start this. Put this key back on. Let's cut this down. Okay. Attempting to communicate. No, but I need to get out of here. Alright, let's just pretend we're going in a state OBD2. Incomplete, still 3. So we're gonna go back. Back up to drive monitors. Still 3. Let's start it up. Do just in case. I'm gonna unplug it and plug it back. And let it get back to where it's supposed to be. It looks like we're gonna be doing some more driving. It's all good. Special test. Drive cycle monitor. So we'll be stopping at 9:40 any day now. Okay, 3 to go. Let's set this over to the side. Let's go find us a gas station with some place I can wash this window down. All right, be right back. Yo, I just gotta show you this, man. Look at this road, man. That is nothing but a sheet of ice. Yeah, all three people around me could drive. I'm glad there's no one around me right now. I am doing about 12 miles an hour right now. I am not even on the gas. I wouldn't even dare hit the gas right now. That is a sheet of ice. All right, I will see you. What is this? I'll see you in 3 miles. We still got 3 incompletes. Wow. Be right back. Yo, you gotta check this out, man. I'm past all the ice. There's no ice up there. This guy's doing like, he's doing like, what, this 5 miles an hour, man? There's no ice on the road. Oh my goodness, yo. All right, we're at 9:39. Dang it. We still got 3, but I'm at a gas station and they got the, yeah, here we go. Can do this windshield. Put this windshield, clean this windshield up. I'm gonna shut this vehicle off. Let's unplug this and then I'll plug it back up when I get back in. All right. Let's go clean this windshield. Look at this thing. This thing is dirty. All right, I'll be right back. All right. Yeah, it's good enough. Boy, I'm glad I was never no car detailer. All right. Let's
hook back up our Actron. Oops, get over here. Hook up back up our Actron. Okay. Some of the key editors. Start it up. Again, we're at 264, 939. Let's over here and global, keep it, yeah, enter. Go down to special test, drive cycle monitors. Oh boy, it's taking, there we go. Okay, there's some bad three ones. Catalyst, evap, and oxygen sensor. All right, let's go over here. Let's put our seatbelt on. I forgot what miles we started at. I don't know, I should have wrote it down or something. Okay. Man, thank you, come apart, man. All right, I will see you at 9:45, unless as soon as another monitor completes, and I'll come back and show you that. All right, let's get to going. Be right back. It's getting kind of dark out here, man. I'm gonna be able to finish this video today. I don't know. We'll see. We'll be back. 9:45. All right, we at 9:45. Getting a little dark out here. And hey man, what the heck? Ah, still at three incompletes. Maybe I get back on 64 and take this to another ride, another drive. Dang it! All right, you know what? Come on, car, move, go, man. What the heck? I am gonna, instead of coming back at 9:50. I'm gonna come back when we get another complete. Or I might come back in 50. I don't know. Whatever way, I'll be back. All right, we're at 9:45. I got two left. Two left, yeah, can you dig it? All right. Oh, 9:46, just turned 9:46. But if your car is a 96 to a 2000, you can get their car inspected right now, and you're gonna pass. Your monitors will be set. But me, I'm the lucky one. I got one more to go. So I gotta set one more monitor, then this car is ready to be inspected. Yeah. Let's go for a ride. Oh, I see some flashing lights down there. Somebody got to an accident. That's a tow truck. I don't know. But we'll be right back. Alright guys, girls, check it out. We have 49. 264, 949. No check engine light. But one monitor. This car's ready to be inspected. I ain't even getting no rail yet, so I can get off, get out of here, take this home. Tomorrow morning, get the car inspected. We're done. There you go. See you guys in a little bit. Let me get back to the house. Astro. Yo, that's so. That tells you all that bull. They be telling you about 400 or 500 miles, 200 miles. It ain't. No, that's bull. Especially with foreign cars, they set really easy. All right. I'll meet you back at the house. Be back. Okay, I'm gonna give you a little bit of update. I'm still on my home. Mileage is 264, 956. No check engine light, but we still have that one incomplete evap. But I'm not worried about it because it's still getting inspected. Just wanted to curious, will it set by the time I get home? It's getting dark out here. Okay, light turned green. I'll be right back.
All right, where the heck we at now? I don't know how many miles up here, man. Thinking blurry, man, and all. But we're pulling up to the yard.
There's the van. Yeah.
All right, so let's pull into the driveway here. Let's see if we can get kind of dark out here. Okay, 264 960. No check engine light.
The airbag light on, but
this still says one. The evap's not set. So what I'm gonna do? Let's shut this off. And I just want to show you, check engine light does work. Okay. Let's go down here and let's go back. I'm gonna go back in. Yeah, still says the one. Let's shut the car off. Put the key on. Shut this door off. And let's go back. Now let's see what it says on state. OBD. Okay, MIL status is off, codes found zero, monitors okay, six, and monitors incomplete one. So we're good to go. We can go. Oh, so let me shut these lights off before I kill this man's battery thing. We're good to go. Let's unhook our Actron so we can close out this video. Where the heck this plug at? Okay, damn, that was a long drive. I don't know. You took a note of how many miles you drove, so. They pull it back in the backyard and we'll be right back. All right, there you have it. You know, stop listening to all these people telling you 300 or 400 miles. There you go, legit. Again, 96 to 2000, you're allowed two to not be set or incomplete. 2001 and up, you only allow one. I just happen to be a 2003, so I only have one. So I can go get this inspected and I'm good to go. But you gotta have some kind of diagnostic equipment. I like the Actron. But anyway, if you have any questions at all, be sure to post them and I'll be sure to comment on them and answer them. It's me or somebody. Sylvia, Mark, Antoine. Guys, girls. Yeah, we back. This is Timmy from Astro Auto Repairs. If we can't repair it, nobody can. You see how dark it's getting out here? I'm hungry. I'm gonna eat dinner. Check y'all later.